Bene, ancora direi due domande. Prego.
I have a rather quick question. You've talked about user-generated content. That's, you know, mainly what your business is about.
Generated, we would say at the bottom of the pyramid.
Well, you're
we would say we own the middle.
You're monetizing what is generated by users anyway.
Yeah, they're not.
I mean, I think someone creates professional. We would call them independent producers.
All right, independent. Fine. My question is, how about this new trend, so-called crowdfunding? A lot of startups are looking at crowdfunding and crowdfinancing platforms in order to seed most of their startups, because you know, everybody here knows that seed capital for a startup based or a dot-com, whatever you want to call it, it's usually the hardest capital to find, and in some cases it's it turns to be quite expensive in terms of coding, because it takes some long hours of coding before you can even say okay, it's open for business. So do you believe in crowdfunding, and do you think there is some trend there that could be positive to the future of startups on the net or not?
I mean, I think it's incredibly exciting. I would say we would think of both of our businesses as being very disruptive, but there hasn't really been a disruptive industry for angel investors or venture capital firms until this. This is a very disruptive trend. There's a company was based out of New York, and they found it too stimulating socially, so they moved to Tahoe to do some coding over the summer. But it's called Diaspora, if I'm pronouncing that correctly. It's sort of a open source competitor to Facebook, and they went on an open platform for crowdsourced fundraising and raised, I think, 100 times what they expected to raise. They raised well over $100,000. Oddly enough, Mark Zuckerberg was one of them, which is amazing. But I think it's exciting. And again, to the question about the brands that I guess he walked out. But if you can build some excitement, build some brand for your startup before it's even started, and get people excited so that they invest in it, that's a really good sign of a good entrepreneur. Because great entrepreneurs are stubborn and they're single-minded, and they'll get their business done no matter what it takes. So cheers to that, I would say.
Thank you.
Questo è un tweet che è arrivato adesso, poi ne abbiamo un altro paio da Luca che li sta seguendo. Comunque Michele Filannino: perché certe idee esplodono negli USA e non nel resto del mondo? Perché certe idee esplodono negli USA e non nel resto del mondo, secondo Luca Conti?
Non so se... No, è chiaro che questa domanda richiederebbe una risposta sul sistema paese. Io inviterei chi ha posto la domanda a confrontare il sistema economico americano col sistema italiano e confrontare gli investimenti in tecnologia con gli investimenti fatti in Italia. Credo confrontando questi dati poi si può avere un'idea della risposta.
There is no question that from no matter which place and which country some ideas like these can come out. The question was why this kind, your kind of company always come from the United States. And of course, Luca, who lives here, knows how heavy is this kind of place for some kind of entrepreneurship.
Starting something.
For starters. But it's also true that there are some good ideas that start from here and become very important. There is something that you would advise to Italians to become known in the States and get excited some Americans about their own idea coming from here.
Is there some advice I can give? Well, Maybe one thing to say about that number is that there are just a lot more companies that are started. You know, there are more companies that are started, and many of them fail. Because there are more started, you hear about more of them. Maybe that's one way of looking at it, one way of thinking about it.
Quindi la prima risposta è statistico. Là ci sono un sacco di aziende, quindi quelle che vengono fuori, che hanno successo, sono di più.
I think the culture has a lot to do with it. So maybe, you know, you think about Japan and in the 60s, 70s, 80s, maybe even early 90s, it was just known for a lot of great electronics, right? So they focused a lot on that. There were a lot of companies that do that there, and you have a few standouts that come out of it. So I think the numbers have something to do with that idea.
Non è del tutto vero che non possano venire fuori. È vero che noi non ne abbiamo così tante da poter avere una casistica significativa. È anche vero, e comunque tutto questo, come dice Luca, in effetti implica una discussione sul sistema paese e sarebbe lunga. Quello che abbiamo imparato è che comunque non c'è nessun motivo perché questo non avvenga. In alcuni casi succede con dinamiche inattese. Io penso che vada segnalato quando un imprenditore di Cagliari scrive un software che usa le API di Twitter per formare un client Twitter che consente di leggere i tweet a colori, dando a ogni colore un significato. Questa cosa viene presentata in Italia, la realizzata e scritta software in Italia. Naturalmente non se ne accorge moltissima gente in Italia, perché comunque gli utenti di Twitter sono pochi in Italia, ma se ne accorge Mashable, che è una delle diciamo bibbie che giudicano la qualità delle idee di questo tipo, e da quel momento lo scrive naturalmente su Mashable, che Twinbow è una buona idea. Viene da Cagliari Luca Filigheddu. Da quando lo scrive Mashable prende quell'onda, sapete, di momentum che fa crescere le idee, e non c'è nessun motivo perché non vada ad avere un buon successo. Quindi l'unica cosa che vorrei dire a questo proposito è che non siamo in Italia. Noi abitiamo in Italia, ma il mondo, la rete è assolutamente internazionale, e il crisma, il trigger, il momento del successo non è necessariamente in Italia, può essere per il mondo. Non chiedete cosa il web può fare per voi, chiedete cosa voi potete fare per il web.